recombinant DNA technology and insulin synthesis. Advancements in molecular biology in the 60s unveiled secrets behind how information is processed on molecular level inside a cell. Scientists around the world looked for ways to manipulate the newly discovered mechanism to advance pharmacology. Those attempts have led to the development of recombinant DNA technology. At the heart of recombinant DNA technology lies the central dogma of molecular biology, which describes the unidirectional flow of sequential information in DNA to RNA through transcription, and from RNA to protein through translation. Recombinant DNA technology takes advantage of this principle by removing a DNA sequence from the genome of one organism and insert it into the genome of another organism. RNA polymerase would then transcribe the information from the DNA sequence to an mRNA. The mRNA leaves the nucleus of the cell to bind to a ribosome and translate the encoded amino acid sequence into a polypeptide. Later advances in molecular biology even allowed for DNA sequences that do not occur anywhere in nature to be made by a chemical synthesis of DNA. With those powerful techniques, scientists and engineers can synthesize protein that an organism wouldn't normally produce. One application of such technology is widely used in the treatment of diabetes. Diabetes, or diabetes mellitus, is a group of metabolic diseases in which there are high blood sugar level over a prolonged period. There are two types of diabetes, and both relates to homeostatic function of insulin. Insulin regulates the metabolism of carbohydrates and fat by promoting the absorption of glucose from the blood to skeletal muscle and fat tissues. In type 1 diabetes, the patient's pancreas secretes little or no insulin. In type 2 diabetes, the patient has become resistant to insulin's action. Insulin therapy is a common treatment for both types of diabetes. Animal insulin derived from bovine and porcine pancreases was the first type of insulin to be administered to humans to control diabetes. With invertebrates, the amino acid sequence of insulin is almost identical. Bovine insulin differs from that of the humans in 3 amino acids, and porcine insulin differs in only 1. This slight variation, however, is still enough to cause animal insulin to have a shorter peak activity time in human compared to its human counterpart. Moreover, the difference can trigger immune responses in some patients, making the treatment problematic. In the search for better substitute for animal insulin, Arthur Riggs and Kaiichi Itakura at Beckman Research Institute synthesized the first recombinant insulin in 1978. Before the actual synthesis, the structure of insulin was heavily studied. The protein itself has two separate chains of amino acids, an A chain with 21 amino acids and a B chain with 30. A and B chain are held together with disulfide bonds. The two insulin chains were grown separately, which required two mini genes, one that encodes the A chain and one for the B chain. DNA sequence that encodes the chain is cut using T4 DNA ligase. Plasmids from a non-harmful type of the bacterium E. coli are extracted. The plasmid is cut open using a specific enzyme at the LACZ gene because it is easy to find and cut. The two DNA molecules are then inserted into the plasmid. The plasmid is closed and mixed up with the bacteria cells. Plasmid enter the bacteria in a process called transfection. E. coli synthesizing the insulin then undergoes a fermentation process. The colony of bacteria replicates roughly every 20 minutes through cell mitosis, and each cell expresses the insulin gene. After a desirable amount of insulin is produced, a mixture of lysosome is added to digest the outer layer of the cell wall. Detergent mixture dissolves the fatty cell membrane. The remains are treated with cyanogen bromide, which separates the insulin chain from the DNA. The last steps involve separation of cell components by size and density with centrifuge. This method of synthesizing insulin is becoming more and more important as the development and spread of technology around the world. Technology has improved the human living condition, but also brought more problems. The number of Americans diagnosed with diabetes is projected to increase 165%, from 11 million in 2000 to 29 million in 2050, prevalence of 4% in 2000 would increase to prevalence of 7.2 in 2050. The largest percent increase in diagnosed diabetes will be among those over the age of 75. With the continuing growth of the number of diabetic patients, demand for insulin would only intensify.